Grenade launcher was developed to compensate for the shortcomings of hand grenades and rifle grenades. A grenade launcher differs from a rifle grenade in that it only fires grenades. Creating a weapon for grenades only was an unacceptable concept in the early days. However, grenade launcher proved to be effective at increasing firepower and accurately hitting a variety of targets. In fact, a grenade launcher is perfect to make a hit in mid-range areas that are too far to aim with a grenade and too short to aim with a mortar. This is a grenade launcher used by the Japanese in World War II. This weapon is more commonly known as the knee mortar and was widely used throughout the Pacific War. There are Type 89 heavy grenade launcher and Type 10 grenade launcher, and they fire 50mm grenades. For the Type 89 launcher, there are two types of grenades that are used. One is a fragmentation grenade, which explodes after a certain period of time after firing. The other is a much more explosive grenade that explodes when it hits a target. First, put a grenade into a barrel. Fix the base plate firmly on the ground and tilt it towards the enemy. Then, pull hard rubber attached to the trigger. When you've done that, a firing pin held in the sear is released and will rise up with the force of the spring. The firing pin at the top will ignite the primer underneath the grenade. As the primer explodes, it ignites the propellant next to it, and the power of the propelling gas generated at this time will blow the grenade away. When grenade hits the target, the primer is ignited and the explosives blast. Fragmentation grenades can be used for various purposes. It can be used as a hand grenade and may also be fired from a grenade launcher by attaching a propellant underneath it. It can also be used as a rifle grenade. When fired by gun's propulsion gas, recoil causes the firing pin to ignite the primer. After that, retarder will burn for about 7 to 8 seconds. Then, detonator is ignited and the explosives burst into flames. The base-plated knee mortar is round-shaped and is fired from the ground or from trees. If you fired the weapon against your knees, as per its name, you could suffer from broken bones. Knee mortar was very effective and easy to use, and provided solution to the shortcomings of mortars against grenades. The concept of recoilless grenade launcher originated in Germany during World War II. The Soviet Union developed this concept and standardized recoilless grenade launchers. The RPG-2 grenade launcher fires an 82mm anti-tank grenade. The weapon system basically consists of a sight and an open-end launching tube with an attached trigger. The sight has three holes. The bottom is used to aim enemies who are 50 meters away, while the middle is to aim ones who are 100 meters away, and finally, the top is to aim ones who are 150 meters away. The grenade can travel up to 200 meters, but its effective range is around 100 meters. Inside the body are molded charge rounds for attacking tanks. The bomb uses TNT and RDX. At the back are tubes and fins that help the bomb fly stably. The tail flaps are folded before firing and automatically unfolds after firing. There is a detonator behind it, followed by a container of propellant. First, insert grenade into launch tube. Put the launcher on your shoulder and aim it at the target and pull the trigger. The pull trigger will hit a firing pin. The firing pin ignites the primer, and the propellant charge also ignites. The force of the propelling gas generated at this time will cause the grenade to fly away. The folded wings spread out, helping the grenade to fly stably. When it hits the target, the ball detonates, igniting the booster and detonating the explosives. There is no recoil, because the propulsion gas is exhausted in the back. The RPG-2 was easy to fire and could be reloaded for use continuously. Indeed, attempts to break free of the limits of grenades continued. With the end of World War II, development of new grenades stalled. However, through the Korean War in 1950, the United States felt the needs for a new type of grenade. Without weapons such as tanks and bazookas, there were very few ways to attack enemies' trenches. To break this through, a 40mm grenade was developed. The 40mm grenade was light, and it flew far, and the generated recoil when fired was small. So there was no need for a large launcher. Development of a grenade launcher has also begun to fire these 40mm grenades. Problems appeared in several models, which were improved and embodied in M79 grenade launcher in 1960. The M79 grenade launcher consists of a stock, barrel group, and sight assembly, among others. The M79 uses a 40mm grenade and can travel up to 400 meters. Despite its ability to send a 400g grenade far enough, its recoil is small. The reason is because it uses a new concept of propulsion system, called high-low propulsion system. Under the cartridge, there is a primer and a propellant that fits into the grenade. The propellant charge is wrapped in the center of the cartridge case and has several holes drilled in it. Place the grenade into the barrel and close the lever until it locks. When the trigger is pulled, the hammer strikes the firing pin. The ball ignites the primer and the propellant powder explodes. Explosive gas does not get ejected in every direction, but only through the holes. The grenade is fired by the pressure of the gas being expelled through the hole. In the high-low propulsion system, the pressure of the explosive gas is concentrated in the center of the casing. This will reduce the pressure that the barrel or cartridge case take. So you can make barrels or cartridges from lighter materials. It can also fire heavy bullets with a small amount of propellant. Therefore, you can use propellants more efficiently than recoilless weapons. When the firing is complete, turn the lever to remove the casing and insert a new grenade. The sight carrier in the rear sight can be moved up and down. If it's down, you'll be able to aim closer, and the farther you'll be aiming, the higher the sight carrier would have to be. For a very close distance, aim without erecting the rear sight. Just align the front sight and the rear sight, then fire. For medium distances, use the sight upright. Match your rear sight and front sight, then fire. When firing long distances, the rear sight rises. So, the launcher is tilted for aiming, and the shoulder strap is lowered below the shoulder for long distance firing. There are rotating bands around the projectile body. The rotating band is engaged with a steel wire and rotates, and the fired grenade rotates at about 3,700 RPM. If the grenade rotates, it can fly stably. The grenade's rotational force also arms the fuse. When the grenade is fired, the firing pin is pulled out of the ball by the setback force. The centrifugal force caused by the grenade's rotation aligns the detonator and the ball with the firing pin. It will take some time to be aligned like this. When it hits the target, an inertial ring pushes the pin out. As the pin is pushed, the lever rotates inward, pushing the ball into the initiator. The initiator ignites the booster and the explosives explode. Arming the fuse by the rotation of the grenade is a kind of safety device. A grenade may not fly far when fired due to defects in the product or mistake by the shooter. Explosions in this state could put the shooter in danger. So, the 40mm grenade uses a fuse that activates primer when it rotates for some time. It usually takes about 10 meters to get the fuse armed. Different types of fuses are used for the 40mm grenade. It was difficult for soldiers to carry grenade launchers and guns at the same time. Carrying only a grenade launcher makes it difficult to defend yourself. Grenade is a long-range weapon, so if the enemy attacked from close, your allies had to help. To overcome these shortcomings, a grenade launcher was created that also serves as a gun. In the next video, we're going to talk about grenade launchers that are fired from guns.